The Ashen Cereal Box by Jeff Rutkowski. Dennis walked down the drawbridge over the moat to the castle. His mother had rented it for the weekend. She had thought it was a good idea, but Dennis didn't think so. He figured he could handle it for 3 days. He'd have his family members to keep him entertained. He stepped through the massive wooden doors into the castle. The castle was huge. It sounded like a church inside the main hall. And he bent down to feel the tiled floor. It felt like marble.
Dennis,
his mother said behind him,
come out to the car and bring in your stuff.
Grumbling, Dennis shuffled outside, across the drawbridge into the sub. When Dennis had unpacked, he decided to check out the castle. He found a couple of doors that led to stairways and one that led to a pool. He figured he would go for a swim later. That night when everybody was asleep, Dennis lay awake listening to the sounds of the frogs outside. It was about midnight when he heard a crash downstairs. He decided to investigate. Broken glass littered the floor beneath the empty window frame. There were some blood stains leading from the window too, well, nowhere that he could find. He turned away from the wall opposite the window. His foot slipped on something.
Whoa.
He fell backward onto a trap door that opened under him. He fell for what seemed like an eternity. When he finally landed, he was on some cushions. The room sounded big like a cave. A steady drip drip of water was all he could hear. Then, far off in the distance, he thought he heard footsteps. Big heavy footsteps, probably a giant's. They got closer and closer. The footsteps finally stopped about 5 feet away. Dennis turned his head and saw a black robed figure about 8 feet tall looking down at him with bloodshot eyes.
Come now!
It growled. Dennis got up and followed it down a stone hallway. The robed figure stopped at a door. As soon as Dennis was about 2 feet away, the figure casually stepped through the solid stone of the door. Dennis pushed it open and stepped through. 15 steps led down to a lower floor. There was about a foot of water that Dennis had to wade through before he got to the wall opposite the steps. The figure pointed to a cabinet with gold letters spelling out the words "Do not disturb." Gomez and Flap, it lies here. Dennis stared.
Open!
The figure growled. Dennis grabbed the handle of the cabinet and pulled. The cabinet swung open. It was empty. Nothing except the yellowed wooden walls.
Find!
Growled the figure.
Your ashes or the whole body?
Dennis asked.
Find!
The figure growled a second time, gesturing toward the steps. Dennis scrambled out of the room and back up to bed. He made sure he was quiet so the rest of the family didn't hear him. He lay awake for several minutes and finally drifted off to sleep. The next morning, Dennis went downstairs for breakfast. He noticed his mother was still wearing that stupid necklace shaped like an urn. Her great-grandfather had died about 100 years ago, and that necklace that supposedly contained his remains was considered a family heirloom. He decided to have some Cocoa Puffs. That and Special K was all they had brought. Yuck! He hated that stuff. It tasted more like cardboard than a box did. After he finished his first bowl, he poured a second. When he glanced at the logo, it glowed bright green. The lettering changed to something like Yak EHTC Akalkan EHT. A second later, the message was gone. He forgot about the cereal and walked to the living room. His mother was sitting on the couch watching reruns of the Brady Bunch.
About that necklace,
Dennis began.
Who did it belong to?
My grandfather, then my mother, and then me.
What was your great-grandfather's name?
I think it was something like Clap or Clap. Anyway, it was very strange. That's why my grandmother changed her maiden name to Floral.
Can I borrow it?
No.
Dennis's mother exclaimed, clutching the necklace to her chest furiously. And so began Plan B. About an hour later, Dennis's mother decided to go outside on the porch to relax. Dennis decided to switch the ashes with kitty litter and take the real ashes downstairs to the cupboard. Oops! He forgot. They didn't have a cat. Oh, well, there was always sand from the moat. He picked coarse-grained sand to substitute the ashes.
Perfect.
He told himself. He went downstairs to the room where the ghost had taken him the previous night. Opening the cupboard, he set the ashes in an urn that had not been there last night. He supposed the ghost had provided it for that purpose. Upon closing the cupboard door, he noticed a message printed in shiny gold lettering where the previous message had been.
Thank you, mortal man. In return, I will give you 3 wishes. Do with them as you please.
A minute later, the message was gone. Dennis walked back through the castle to the living room. He knew he would be in huge trouble for stealing his mother's necklace, but he could see to that by using his first wish.